Hi everybody, welcome back to Sipsville. Oh my god, we're doing a lot better. We are doing a lot better now. This is great. We killed a ghost last episode. Juliana got some perps. Oh my god, this is fantastic. She's gonna be unstoppable now. When we go down into the dungeons, she's gonna just turn into like a crazed lunatic, and everybody's gonna be like, "Oh my god, I'm so surprised Juliana had that in her to actually go like crazy." But she'll be bloodlusting like there's no tomorrow. We got some food stocked up. We got four breads. We got our pig pens, which we need to finish off soon. I don't know why people keep avoiding all these pigs. Pigs aren't that bad. They're fairly clean. They don't smell or anything. They're kind of cute. You could have them as pets or whatever. So I think these people should be doing all they can to get really close to pigs and cuddle with them and pick them up and throw them around, swing them around like little babies. Oh yeah, that's how you want to deal with a pig, definitely. But yeah, we need a lot of pigs to get these pens done. There don't seem to be any pigs coming out of this pen, and but there's one healthy pig here, but nobody wants to go near him. So there we go. Hopefully these pens will get finished off fairly quickly, and then we can start busting out the pork pies. Oh boy, Juliana's gonna put on so much weight. She's gonna get big, luscious love handles, and everybody is just gonna be like, "Wow, what a sassy bitch walking around town with her perps on." Oh, it's gonna be fantastic. I can't wait. Personally, I cannot wait. Okay, so we moved all the wood out of here last episode, and that was good. That means we've got all this wood in here so that anytime anyone does anything in here, they have to go no further than this crappy barrel. And we're gonna do the same thing with the masonry area, and then we're gonna give some walls to the forge to do the same thing there too. We're gonna move some iron and coal in there, and then can just store like a bunch of crap that we don't really use down here, because it's a bit of a trek. We should probably connect all this stuff together at some point too, but that can wait. That can wait for now. Well, let's get some wooden walls up here around the forge, and this will be great. Here we go. We'll just build this like this. Oh boy. And then that'll be enclosed. And while we're waiting for that to happen as well, let's get some raw materials, barrels here. Oh, I forgot to hold shift again. And we just need a door too. Wooden door. Oh boy. Oh, Sipsville is really taking shape now. This is great. We've only got one bread stockpiled. I think we've got enough wheat farms. And we definitely have enough mills. We just need people to actually bake the bread and stop eating it. Juliana is obviously just stocking up for the winter. It's gonna be a long winter, and oh shit, you know what I just realized? Probably just ran. Oh yeah, fuck, that's why. God, I gotta stay on the ball with that. I took off these minimum orders, so now I'm doing them manually, and I totally forgot that we're probably gonna have a famine now. Oh jeez, I'm saying thank, but obviously I don't mean thank Christ or anything. Oh sweet, we got a pig pen. That makes up for it. That's fine. Okay, well, good job anyway, whoever that was, Eleanor, for doing that. That's great. We can disable all on that, and let's start accepting some iron, which means that we don't want to accept iron down here anymore. We could keep a nice stockpile of 10 iron, and that'll be more than enough. We're gonna disable iron on all of these barrels. I know there's a lot of barrels, but basically we're just gonna keep them for like mud and other shit that we end up taking up when we're quarrying and stuff. Okay, phew. There's not going to be a famine, thankfully, because actually the priorities are being followed now. Baking and cooking is priority number one, and that's exactly what they're doing. They've seen that there's some orders to make breads manually, so they've come out here, they've harvested the wheat, and they're going to take it, turn it into flour, bring it back in here, and Demetrius is going to, with just his sheer rage, he doesn't even need these baker's ovens. He's just going to stand next to the bread, the uncooked bread, and his anger alone will be hot enough to make the bread crispy and rise. And oh fuck yeah, that's fantastic. You gotta love a bit of rage, especially Demetrius's rage. That's why we gave him his own house. So when he does have a nuclear meltdown, he's far away from everybody else. Nobody's gonna get damaged by the fallout. He can just rage like there's no tomorrow in these four walls. And he goes crazy too. He throws himself against the walls. He's like punching the stone walls. That's why we had to make these walls out of stone, so he couldn't punch through them. Because if it was wood, he would just go Mr. Miyagi on that shit and just like bust right through and scare the shit out of Eleanor, who's already had a really tough time with Sadon. I mean, Sadon was just an absolute animal. Oh God, this poor pig. I mean, what's wrong with this pig? How come nobody wants to give this pig some love? Look at him, he's so cute. He's just like idling around out here, and everyone's just like, oh, whatever. Like, they don't care about that pig. God, so mean. I think once we get some more bread, oh my God, we don't actually have a lot of bread. I think the wheat farms are what are holding us up now. Oh no, there's bread in there too. Okay, good. We've got a little stockpile of bread. That's fine. We're going to have to chop down some wood. Probably make some more wheat farms soon too. But let's make sure that we get a bit of bread first before we put that order in. Although, actually, with the priorities, it should be fine. There we go. We're just going to clear cut this shit. Oh yeah. God. Mother Nature's going to really hate us, but it doesn't matter. No ghosts. Just doing my ghost check. I like to check on the ghosts, just to make sure. And here we go. We've got one bread. That's not nearly enough. Get out of my forge, chicken. What the hell are you doing in here? Let's kill you. That'll teach you. You should never step into a man's forge. And now Matilda's going to strangle you with her bare hands. Her hairy man hands. Matilda is very feminine, actually. She looks very, very pleasing to the eye, except that she just has these really disgusting ogre hands. Like, man, they're all blistered and everything, because she's just doing, like, so much manual labor. That's a big turnoff for people. I mean, she doesn't have any gloves. We haven't given her any gloves. So, you know, those man hands are just on display at all times for everybody to see. And nobody's particularly impressed. Actually, they're really disgusting. And, well, Juliana just finished a bit of bread, and she's just going to come up for some more. Actually, we don't need you as a soldier right now, Juliana. We need you to get stuck in. So we're going to convert her to a civilian. She can eat some more bread, and then she can start helping out. And then when we see a ghost or anything else that needs to be destroyed, or, you know, if there's a target dummy, if we ever build a target dummy and she wants to show off how great she is at making big yellow numbers, then that's fine. We'll convert her back to a soldier. But for now, she's a civilian. She's going to help out. She's mucking in. She's going to muck in with all the rest of these dopes. And, God, Pig Watch carries on. This pig just has been shown no love whatsoever. I'm going to leave him there, though. I don't want to kill him yet. And hopefully these other pig pens finish off soon, too. Once we get some of that wood down, and oh yeah, the forge will be finished. Oh, Christ almighty. I hope these people are planning on... Actually, let's cancel all this, because I think we're low on bread again. Can you believe it? That's enough wood for now, anyway. I'll cancel all this crap, too. Don't you even think about it, bastards. Look, they were all coming down like, oh yeah, we're going to cut more wood. But no, I canceled the orders. Before they get too hungry, they're all going to come back here, hopefully, start making some bread. And look at, here's a whole army of them. Ah, it's the bread brigade. They're coming to harvest the fields in numbers, like a whole horde of people ready to harvest. Oh yeah, they're going to make flour in massive quantities, and then they're going to cook up some breads. Oh God, we've got this so sewn up now. We've got this under control. Even if anyone starts starving now, it doesn't matter. Everybody's all over the bread. They want to make the bread, want to knead it themselves, like with their bare hands. Rice is very good at, and Demetrius for that matter, very good at slicing the bread with their axes now, which is very good. Oh, actually, we want to disable all of that. This one's going to be for coal. Here we go. So let's enable some coal, and then let's disable coal on all these. Oh yeah, here we go. We're going to have so many materials on hand. It's going to be so fantastic. Right where we need them too. You know, the minute we want to make some like really awesome nuclear weapons, it's going to be sweet. Nobody's going to get in our way. They're going to be, all the materials we need are going to be right there. Somebody can come in and just grind all night long making the weapons, and then we can start tooling people up. Oh God, we can make some iron armors and stuff as well. Oh, it's going to be so amazing. This is really, this last house here is going to be it for now. Once we get the walls up on this, we can start making some better living quarters for people, attract more people, tool them all up, and then it's dungeon time. We're not too far away now. It's just making sure that we keep everything under control, like bread production and pen production, which isn't going too well at the moment. We need some more pigs so that we can start making pies, and we can fill these people up so that they don't need to eat every 5 seconds, and then we should be good. But until then, we just have to sort of wait around, wait for them to finish up all this junk, Watch, Bryce looked like he was skipping there for a minute, like frolicking through the field in his like bone armor and his with his iron axe. That would be terrifying. I mean, don't get me wrong, it would be pretty terrifying if you were in a field all alone. You saw a Death Knight in full bone armor charging at you and yelling. But equally terrifying if he was like hop skipping through the field and maybe singing like tunes from The Sound of Music. I think either way I'd be shit scared. Don't know about you, but I'm eager to know. So, you know, if you want to let me know, you know, Twitter me or something, and we can talk about it. It'll be. Oh my God, I forgot that I gave Muriel a bone helmet and wooden armor. God, she looks like a bit. I don't know. Maybe we can give her like some leather underpants and some stone shoes, and then she'll have like the perfect mismatch of fashion, just like a fashion disaster. Oh God, we're out of breads, but these people are actually baking more, so that's good. I have to up this again. Let's just up this to like 20. There we go. See what happens there. Well, they should still make the bread anyway, so that'll be good. We're gonna need some more wheat fields soon too. I'm gonna get those down now. Here we go. Good thing I tilled all that land like 4 episodes ago or whatever and never used it, because it's gonna come in handy now. We should have more than enough wood, so that's good. And is automatic mode on for all this stuff? It should be. I think I'm pretty sure I turned it all on. Yeah, we did. We're all over this. This is fantastic. Oh God, yeah. Got iron. We still don't have any coal in there, but that's because everybody's making bread. And as they should be too. God, stupid bastards. Juliana is. Oh my God, Juliana, every time I see you, you're hungry and eating. This isn't good. I mean, I hope Juliana's not like not pregnant or anything, because that is a lot of eating for one woman to do. But you know, I guess she works up an appetite when she's fighting ghosts. No ghosts to fight right now, thank God. God, those ghosts are a real pain. Especially the ones that killed Zadon. Jesus. Oh, fantastic! Look at that. We've got 3 pig pens now. Jesus. The pigs should just be like spilling out now. I don't know where they all are, but well, there's still this guy over here. Oh, poor Timmy. Poor Timmy, all alone in the field. I'm tempted to kill him, but I just feel a bit bad for him. He's just been so neglected. Oh, who's this? Ariel, what are you doing? How come you're just tired? She just got tired like at the last minute and dropped the wood next to the field and didn't bother. Oh my God, that is. Oh wow, okay. Anne's actually starving now. Who else is starving? Do we have more starving people? No, we've got Matilda who's starving. And we've got, well, we've got flour, but they've decided to actually build these farms over actually baking the bread. So we're not even gonna waste any time. Oh God, I can't even cancel this order. This is unbelievable. I'm just gonna have to destroy it. Here we go. Let's destroy these. I know I've wasted wood, but can't have people wasting time on this. We need to build some bread. We need to build some bread to last. Before it's too late, and it looks like it's up to Juliana, who's not going to do it. She's not going to harvest any wheat, but that's okay. Gloriana's going to do it. No, Juliana's more interested in coal, apparently. Poor Anne. Poor Anne might just actually starve to death. Juliana's still. Oh no, she's doing it. She's actually harvesting the wheat, and well, we've got flour here too. I don't know why they're not using the flour to make bread. Let me just double check. This is a real problem. Food is just like such a ball ache in this game. Getting it up and running properly is almost impossible. Here we go. We got 3 people building bacon breads now. So anyone who's starving should be able to come up and eat the bread, unless one of these bastards eats it ahead of them, which would be quite funny. But I don't think it's gonna happen. I think as soon as one goes down on the ground, we'll get who's this? Oh yeah. Hungry, but not hungry enough to crawl up and eat the bread, Matilda. So there we go. And who's that? Anne still needs some bread. Oh my God, Demetrius is starving too. Jesus, everybody's pretty hungry. We're gonna have to get a little bit of a stockpile going before we start building some more stuff, I think. And how are we doing with this wood out here? Okay, we're not doing too bad. Poor Bryce is starving now too. Jesus Christ. That's probably Bryce's, because it looks like Anne's had hers now. And that's good. Everybody who was actually starving, God, it's like a little mini famine there again. It was happening again. I can't believe it. Too many orders. That's the problem, I guess. Bryce is gonna have his bread. Matilda's just gone hungry, so she's got a couple of weeks to go before she actually starves to death, but it shouldn't be a problem, because Gloriana's all over it. And amazing, we're actually cooking bread whilst finishing off the walls here, and hauling coal, apparently, too, Eleanor. Good job. Such a team player. Should be hauling a lot of wood back here, which, yeah, seems to be happening. Looks like everybody's going out here to get this wood. And then we'll get those wheat fields up too, because it looks like now we're on sort of like a cool down for the wheat fields, because they should be jumping out here as soon as they can to get the wheat turned into flour, and they seem to be doing that. Now we've harvested it all, so we're gonna need some more wheat fields, but that's okay. We'll just wait. We'll wait until all of that wood is hauled back, and wait for this to finish, and in the meantime we should be able to sustain what we've got. We should be fine. I don't think anyone is. Oh, Muriel's now starving, but once again, not for too long. What the hell's going on down here? Look at this. Look what they've done with this coal. What a bunch of animals. Jesus, look, there's freaking coal everywhere. God damn it. I'm not angry or anything. I mean, don't get me wrong. I think it's great that there's a lot of coal laying around in the dining room and in the kitchen as well, and all over the goddamn place in the storage room too. Really good job, guys. Really thinking with your heads. God, these people are just insufferable. Who's this now? Oh yeah, it's Demetrius. Demetrius is baking some bread. Got who's that? Matilda baking some bread. Oh god, it's fantastic when they actually bake the bread. It actually warms my heart. Let's just make sure that we're always baking bread. I'm just gonna make like thousands of these. Here we go. That's 35 breads. Fantastic. I'm gonna need some more containers for coal too. Jesus Christ. Who's this now? Ah, Juliana, not you. God, anyone but. Oh look, somebody's actually put wheat into that barrel. Jesus Christ, that's the first time I've ever seen that. Well, I've seen it in a long time. We definitely need some more people, but I'm too scared to get them because I don't want to get sieged. I don't want the town to go down the crapper. Fuck. There's two breads in there. What are you doing, Muriel? Like, has somebody else sent you a memo saying, no, you can't have these breads? There's two sitting in that container. Why are you sitting there starving? I don't get it. Really don't get it. Maybe somebody's coming from like the other side of the map to eat that bread. Or maybe not. Jesus Christ. Demetrius, what are you actually doing? Are you... Okay, you are baking bread. Fantastic. Oh, I guess she was standing in the way of the bread so nobody could get it. Wow. That's amazing. Well, Juliana's going to come in and eat her bread. Eleanor is now starving as well. But we've got some wheat. Oh no, we don't have wheat now. Do we have any flour? Jesus Christ, we don't have any flour either. Fuck, this is pretty close again. I mean, it's not a full-blown starvation, but Jesus, it's not too far off. Which wood is in there? Two woods. Okay. Let's get another raw materials container in here. And we'll devote that to coal once it's built. Oh, look at that. Matilda's like all over it. She's just like, she was just ready. She was waiting in the wood shop. And then somebody said, we need another raw materials barrel. And Matilda's like, oh my god, I'm going to do it. And she's all over it. Did she actually build it though? Can't even tell. No, I think she's just going to go pick up some more wood. Oh god, she's so stupid. And I think Bryce might actually finish it off. Going to do it? No, he's going to leave it for Matilda. Fantastic. Wow, where did that wheat come from? Oh, don't tell me they're putting wheat in here. Jesus Christ. What a bunch of dummies. Seriously. Is this actually happening? I can't believe this is happening. This is just bad management. This is my fault, actually. Don't worry about it. Is there any flour down here? No, there isn't. I don't even know why we want to store these down. Actually, let's just destroy these stupid raw... God, we don't even need these here. They're just causing problems. They're making people... take the longest route possible to get the supplies. Oh my god, this is a nightmare. Jesus Christ, look at all this coal. We need to start hauling this coal out of here. And look at all these people that are hungry coming down to eat their breads. Demetrius is now hungry, and we want to disable all here, and we just want to enable coal, so that should be fine. Two breads. We need another bread for Anne, who is collapsed inside this barrel and is barring the way to all this wood. Oh, Jesus Christ, Anne. She's got, like, her whole butt is stuck into the opening of the barrel, and nobody... Oh, no, that's... I'm lying. I'm telling you a lie, because Matilda just deposited some more wood in there, so that's okay. Let's get this wheat farm going. Here we go. We should have enough wood there to actually build it without making people trek all the way out here. Although, that doesn't stop Jocelyn. She wants to go on a massive trek to get wood. And that's fair enough, really. Here we go. We got prepared food here. We never use these. I'm just going to destroy this. I'm destroying this, and I'm going to destroy this one as well. I'm also going to destroy these two as well, because they're friggin' useless. I mean, we never get enough bread to fill these barrels in the first place. Hopefully we can get this wheat farm up. God damn it. I think Demetrius might actually die. That would be very sad. Let me just check my bread orders. I'm sure I've got... Yeah, wow, they built 5 since the last time I jacked it all up. Jesus Christ. Here we go. Who's this? Muriel. Fantastic. With your flour. Not taking the flour, though. Too busy, harvesting. Well, that's fine. At least she's harvesting. Not like Juliana that time, who, just refused to actually make any food while the whole town was dying. Oh, Jesus, here. Look at this. Look at these three are starving now, too. We should have enough flour to make some breads to get them out of that, though. Be another flour here now, too. There we go. Tons of flour. So if we can turn this around... Oh, God. At least the whole town isn't starving, though. That's at least something. Juliana and... who's this? Is that Bryce? Yeah, it's Bryce. They're gonna cook up some breads, and, God, all of our pig pens are finally done, too. That's great. At least that's happened. At least that's good. And, you know, we can start putting in some orders to actually, make some pork pies, which will be very good. Let's make some cooked pork. Let's get 5 of these bad boys. Here we go. This is gonna be great. And we're gonna accept them in here. So where's the pork pie? Pork pie must be over here? No? I don't see it. I can't see it. It's here. Prepared food. Pie. Mushroom soup. Cooked pork. There it is. I was looking for pork pie. Prepared food. Oh, yeah. Okay, sweet. So, they should kill some pigs, cook up the pork, and then deposit that in there. And then that should fill up people more so that they won't go starving every 5 seconds. Because bread only fills you up 80%. So, after a while, and... after all you've done is eat bread, you just tend to get very hungry very quickly. But we seem to be doing okay for now, though. We're not doing too badly. We seem to be maintaining... oh yeah, there's some wood there, too. We'll chop down some stuff closer to home, too. Just get those logs in here, and then we can build some more wheat farms, because we need them, Jesus Christ. These people are probably spending a lot of time hauling this coal, too, because, Jesus, there's so much coal just laying on the ground there, and, oh, Jesus, I don't know why there's so much of it down there, but that's okay. We'll start using it soon, because we'll put some orders in for weapons and stuff, but hopefully Juliana will make some flour, make some bread, and then we won't lose Muriel St. Clair. That would be great, but you never know. So hard to tell. God, this game is so random sometimes. It's great, though. It is a great game. Okay, I think we'll end there anyway. We managed to get the walls done in the forge anyway. Managed to get the rest of the pig pens built, which is really good. So that means we can start making some pork, cooked pork. We'll save these people who are starving. We'll get the rest of these wheat fields set up, and then we'll start building some weapons, and then we'll go take a look at the dungeon. So, as usual, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you for the next one.